being in town. Brother Billy said something a few minutes ago, how God appreciates just what little bit of time that we do give him.
Yeah.
Brother Billy, when you said that, I got to thinking about this past Sunday, which was my birthday.
Yeah.
You don't know what it made me feel like Sunday morning.
I'm on.
When I see my daughter and her husband and the kids come through that back door.
Yeah. Amen.
Come on. That's the way God feels.
Yeah. Oh.
When he sees his children coming to a church, amen. That's the way he feels. Amen. What a blessing it was to me, amen. Did that night, my son, Amy, and all the kids, yeah. They showed up. One of my brothers.
Yeah.
His wife, my sister, her husband.
Amen.
What a blessing. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
It touches your heart. Amen. If that don't touch your heart, something wrong with your heart.
Come on.
And that's the same way that does the Lord when he looks down and he sees that his child has come to worship him.
Come on.
Even though, Sister Richie, he knows what kind of day I've had.
Yeah.
He knows what kind of day you've had. If you've been battling and you've been trying and all that stuff. And when he looks down, and especially when he sees knows what kind of day you've had.
Come on.
And he knows that you had to fight the devil all day long, and trials and battles have been going on at you all day long. Then he sees you down there.
Yeah.
Honey, it's got to shake you up. Amen. It's got to bring a tear to his eye. Amen. When he sees his children still willing to come worship you.
Amen.
Even though the devil's just told everything in the world at him, Brother Bill.
Come on.
He still looks down and he sees that you're still standing for him.
Yeah.
It's got to move his heart.
Amen.
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 It'll move his heart.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. It'll move his heart. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We don't really realize how much power our God's got.
Come on.
Amen.
Yeah.
He's got more power than we really realize. Amen.
Amen.
There is nothing that my Bible tells me there's nothing.
Come on.
Brother Billy. That means there isn't anything that's not impossible with God.
Come on.
Anything that we have need of, Sister Richie, he's got it.
Come on.
Amen. If we'll trust him and believe and call upon him, he'll answer. Amen. But we got to know who we're calling upon.
Come on.
Amen. So through the Bible, you'll find out, over in 1 Kings, you'll find out they had a fake God.
Yeah.
And they got in a little challenge, Brother Billy.
Come on.
He said, you make your offering, you get it all ready, and you call on your God.
Come on.
Then I'll get mine ready, then I'll call on my God, and we'll see who's God answered. Amen.
Amen.
And when he went out and they made their offering ready and they called on their God and wouldn't get no answer.
Come on.
The Bible says they're gods. They called on their gods, Billy.
Yeah.
Amen. They called on their gods and they wouldn't get no answer. They even took things and cut themselves and bled trying to get their God to answer.
Yeah.
But there was no answer.
Come on.
Then Elijah had the same offering laid out.
Come on.
But he's really going to show them what his God could do.
Yeah.
He told him, give me some water. And pour it upon it. And I'll call down the bar.
Come on.
And they went once and they got water, Brother Billy, and they poured it on it.
Yeah, come on.
He said, get me some more.
Yeah.
Amen. So they went the second time, they got water and they poured it on. And he said, get me one more time.
Come on.
And they got water and they poured it all over to even build the fridges up around it.
Yeah.
But when he called on his God, say he knew it, Brother, he knew the power of his God.
Come on.
Amen. He knew when he called upon him that he was going to answer. And when he called, the fire come down and assumed the sacrifice and dried up all the water.
Yeah.
Amen. Because he knew what kind of power his God got.
Come on.
We're serving the same God, church.
Yeah.
Amen. We're serving the same God. They even asked that person, so what's wrong with your God?
Come on.
Is he too busy yet? He made fun of him.
Yeah.
Or is he asleep? Or Brother Hinton used to say, is he on the potty?
Yeah, come on.
Amen. Make fun of him. Amen.
Come on.
Most of us, if we make fun of somebody, then when it comes our turn, we say, uh-oh.
Yeah.
We done messed up.
Come on.
Is our God really going to answer? But he didn't have no doubt.
Yeah.
Because he knew the power of his God. Amen. See, that's what David knew when he went out to fight the giant.
Come on.
When Saul tried to put the armor on him, the armor wouldn't fit, Brother Billy.
Come on.
He said, matter of fact, he said, I haven't proved this armor.
Yeah.
So I haven't tested this armor. I don't know if it'll work or not. Amen.
Come on.
But he said, I can't wear this armor. But he said, I have tested this other armor I got.
Oh, Hallelujah.
They delivered me out of the land and the front of the bear. Amen. They delivered him. So when he went out to fight that giant, he didn't just go with the sling and five little stones.
Come on.
That ain't what defeated Goliath.
Yeah.
That's not what defeated the giant.
Amen.
What defeated the giant wasn't the sling, it was the name that he covered.
Come on, yeah.
He said, I come to you, you come to me, Spirit, Lord, I come to you in the name of the Lord.
Whoa,
amen.
Hallelujah.
He knew what power his name God had. Amen.
Come on.
He knew that when he went out that he was going to beat him. Amen.
Yeah.
Because he knew and whom he was serving. Amen. The Bible talks about in 2 Timothy. Turn over with me, we go. 2 Timothy 1:12 says, let me get my eyes on. For this which cause I also suffer these things, nevertheless I am not ashamed, for I know in whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able. Keep that which I have commanded unto him against that day. See, I'm persuaded. We got to get persuaded, brother.
Yeah.
We got to learn and who we really trust in.
Yeah.
Amen. When they told the three Hebrew boys, when they told them to bow to their God, it said, if you don't, we're going to throw you in that fire furnace. And they told them, said, our God is able to deliver us. But even if he don't, I'm not going to bow. Amen. They was persuaded, Brother Billy.
Yeah.
They was persuaded in who they was doing. They knew who they was putting their trust in. Amen. It's one thing to believe in God, but it's another thing to trust in.
Come on.
Amen. Church, we got to learn to trust him. Even the more so as we see these last days approaching. We got to learn to trust God. You think it's rough now? It's fixing to get rough.
Yeah.
It's fixing to get tough, and it's fixing to get rough. Amen.
Come on.
It's going to get a whole lot worse than what we're seeing right now, Brother Billy. Amen.
Amen.
And we're going to have to learn, and we're going to have to trust God.
Come on.
Amen. It ain't going to be good enough just to believe in him.
Come on.
Just about anybody you talk to, they know who Jesus is.
Amen.
You can ask them, say, well, yeah, I know Jesus.
Come on.
But does Jesus know them?
Yeah.
That's the whole question. Well, if not, he knows you.
Come on.
Amen. It ain't just because you know him. He's got to know you. Because if he don't know you, then he can't put your name in that book.
Come on.
And if your name ain't written in that book, it don't matter how much you know of him. If you don't, he don't know you. Amen.
Amen.
He said, depart from me. I never knew you.
Yeah.
Amen. Mm-hmm. But the Hebrew boys, they knew who they was trusting in.
Come on.
And that's what we got to learn. We got to learn that we can't just believe in him. We got to trust in him.
Yeah.
Amen. Brother Harry told a story one time about a man was out on a cliff. And in between two cliffs, there was a big valley. And they stretched a rope across that cliff. And there's a big crowd on this cliff and a big crowd on that cliff. And one guy said, I believe I can walk across that rope. And the crowd got behind him, yeah, come on, cheering him on. So he started on. And he walked across the rope. He got to the other side, and he said, I believe I can walk back over. They was cheering him on. Yep, we believe he can too. He got back on the other side. He said, I believe I can go back one more time. They said, yeah, we believe you can too. He said, but this time I believe I can carry one of you on my back. He didn't have no takers.
Yeah.
One thing to believe. They believed that he could walk across there.
Come
they
on.
Didn't have no trust for to carry them across. Amen. There's one thing to believe, but another thing to trust him. Amen. We're going to have to learn to trust him. We're going to have to learn to put our faith in him. Amen.
Amen.
We just come out of a great revival at our church. Amen. God moved in mighty ways. Amen. God is still in the miracle business. God is still doing things. Amen.
Amen.
And he's still working. Brother Bill, I've been having a battle with one of my people.
Yeah.
I don't call no names in my church. They didn't want to worship. They just want to sit and look down the whole time he was preaching. And it's been bothering me. And I've been praying about it and battling about it. And I thought, man, when I have this revival, he's really going to get upset.
Yeah.
He really ain't going to like this. And the Lord is my witness. We don't know what God's got planned.
Come on.
And the Lord is my witness standing here tonight. He got more blessing in that revival than anybody in that church.
Amen.
Amen. He got up. He raised his hands up. He was praising God. See, we always think this is going to happen.
Yeah.
But God had it all planned out.
Come on.
Amen. And I was worried about that he was going to count some kind of scene. He wasn't going to like the preacher. He wasn't going to like the music. And all the time, God was saying, have this revival for him.
Come on.
I mean, there were a lot of people got blessed. I got blessed, amen, but it was for him too, amen. See, God knows what he's doing, church, but we got to put our trust in him. So many times we just put our trust in ourselves, amen. I mean, I see it even, and I'm learning, just being a pastor and stuff, you know, I'm just learning all this stuff, but I can't put my trust in what I know.
Yeah.
Amen. I can't put my trust in what somebody else is trying to tell me. I got to put my trust in the Lord. Let him lead me, amen. Let him guide me, amen. See, I can jump up and say, well, this is right and that's wrong, and this is right and that's wrong. The first thing you know, I have a whole church to work. Amen. Yeah. But if I put it in God's hand and put the trust in his hand, turn everything over to him, let him take care of it all, he'll work it out.
Amen.
He'll work it out. Amen.
Amen.
He'll work it out. Brother Billy, he's a powerful, mighty God.
Amen.
We serve a mighty God. Amen. But we got to believe that he's powerful.
Come on.
How big our God is, it's how big we let him be.
Yeah.
That's how big he is.
Amen.
He's just as big as we'll let him be. But that's the same way it works for the devil, too.
Yeah.
He's just as big as you let him be. And most of the time, we run around letting the devil be bigger than God.
Come on.
Amen.
Oh, that's good.
Amen. Most of the time, that's what we do. We run around and let the devil be bigger than God. We got to put our faith in God. Put our trust in him. Amen. He'll see us through, church. I promise you, he ain't going to let us fail. He ain't going to forsake us. Amen. It may look rough. Times is going to get harder and tougher. And it may look rougher and rougher, Brother Billy. But if we'll hang on to Jesus.
Amen.
He promises he'll see us through. Every promise in this book is for us.
Amen. Amen.
If we'll grab hold of it and believe it.
Yeah.
But we got to believe it.
Yeah.
We got to get rooted and grounded in it and not let nothing shake us from his word.
Yeah.
Amen. Said, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word will stand. So his word will stand if we'll trust it and believe
Amen.
It.
Amen.
Amen. That's what the Lord gave me. Give the Lord a hand for his word.
Praise the Lord.